Hello and welcome to XNS's educational video introducing swing trading with Fibonacci. The core of Fibonacci is used in various different fields, not just trading, mathematics, computing, various others. It's just a sequence of numbers in which each entry is the sum of the previous two. But the idea that retracements can be predictable percentages of the initial movement is the basis of Fibonacci retracements. They are primarily used to help find entries and exits, but they can also be used to help find support and resistance used for setting stops and targets. So in this example, we've got the weekly chart of gold against the dollar, really quite a high time frame. And we set up Fibonacci retracements based on the large upward movement from August 2018 until the middle of 2020. And we can see from the various areas of retracement possible supports and resistances, some of which do seem to be quite accurate, particularly the area just below $1,700, which might be a good candidate for a stop if somebody were to buy in. And equally for a target, it's possible, of course, to use the latest high, but if you were buying in lower, for example, if the price retraced down to just above 1,600, the target could possibly be this area up here. And various other permutations are also possible depending upon the desired length of the trade being open. While retracements are the most popular Fibonacci tool by far among retail traders in general, there are various other Fibonacci tools that can be used, including expansions, fans, time zones, arcs, and various others. We're going to just look very briefly at fans in practice and also describe the essential principle of how extensions can be used. More so than retracements, fans are most useful during strong trends. They're drawn in basically the same way as retracements, but the lines are angled upwards or downwards according to the direction of the trend. And to some degree, an alternative use of Fibonacci is extensions, which can provide possible targets, particularly on the charts of commodities and cryptocurrencies, which tend generally to have quite strong trends. Expansions, bear in mind, do come as standard with retracements in MT4 and MT5, so it can, for many traders, be more convenient to use these platforms than TradingView and related platforms to set Fibonacci. Now, taking a look at fans in practice, here on the weekly chart of Bitcoin, which has, of course, been a very, very active cryptocurrency over the past couple of years. And the primary purpose of this fan, and we're looking mainly, but not exclusively, at these three lines in the center here to determine possible areas of support and resistance for the trend. And the central line of the three is to some degree used as a trend line. But we should bear in mind, of course, that when we're using Fibonacci, trend Fibonacci tools, that is to say fans and extensions with cryptocurrencies, they can lead to very aggressive targets. Cryptocurrencies are, of course, very volatile. So it's important with Fibonacci, as with basically anything else in trading, not to rely only on that one source, but where possible, to use other sources of confirmation as well before acting on any signals. So in summary, Fibonacci retracements are the most popular Fibonacci tool among traders in general, helping to find entries and exits and support and resistance. Fans can be quite similar, but are generally more useful during strong trends, and they can also help to project potential targets. Extensions are arguably even better at doing that than fans, and they can also perform some of the same functions as retracements and fans, depending on the context and the strength of the trend. Of course, in any case, it's a very good idea to experiment with using the different Fibonacci tools to find which one works best for you. Thank you for watching XNS's educational video introducing swing trading with Fibonacci. I hope you found it informative, and if so, we would really encourage you to watch the various other videos in this series about similar topics.